Hi friends, in this video we are going to see inverse Laplace transform. Before you continue this video, please go through. There are some other videos I uploaded related to Laplace transform. That is why we need to go for Laplace transform. After that, basic definition of Laplace transform and Laplace transform standard signals, and finally partial fraction expansion. Then how the partial fraction expansion is useful to find out the inverse Laplace transform. So these are the 5 videos I already uploaded. So please watch those videos. The links for those video is given in description. So please watch those videos. After that continue watch this video. Then only you can easily understand the content of this video. Because in this video I'm going to purely deal with inverse Laplace transform. Okay, if you have a prior idea about partial fraction expansion, then only you can easily understand inverse Laplace transform. Okay, so first we will see here the inverse Laplace transform definition. What is inverse Laplace transform definition? This is inverse Laplace transform of x of s. What is x of s? If you are having originals in the x of t, if you are taking Laplace transform, then that will be x of s. X of s is the signal which is in S domain. Okay, so this is a time domain signal and it is S domain signal. And again, after doing some analysis, if you want again the original signal means, then we have to go for inverse Laplace transform. Original signal is x of t. Okay, so inverse Laplace transform x of s is equal to x of t, that is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi j integral of S varies from sigma minus j omega to sigma plus j omega, then x of s e power st ds. This is the basic definition of inverse Laplace transform, but you cannot easily perform this integration operation. So because it is a tedious job, so generally people will go for partial fraction expansion to find out the inverse Laplace transform. In this way, the step one will be you have to represent the given x of s into a sum of first order or and second order sections. First order and r. Okay, it is not just and, it may be only you can represent the given x of s using first order section itself, as sometimes we have to represent the given x of s into first order as well as second order sections. After that, this is step two, I have to take the inverse Laplace transform using standard Laplace transform pair. Okay, so that's why I already told you, if you want to understand this particular video means content of this video, but first you should know the standard Laplace transform. Okay, so that's why I suggest you to watch those previous videos I uploaded. Okay, so here we are going to see 3 examples. Each examples are having different types. Okay, first example we'll see. Determine the inverse Laplace transform of the following: x of s is equal to 1 minus 2 s squared minus 14 s divided by s into s plus 3, s plus 4, and here we are going to take the first partial fraction expansion to find out the x of t. So x of s can be represented here, it is represented using a first order section itself. Each one is first order, sum of the first order section. Okay, so to find out here a b c, everything is called residues. To find out the a, I have to multiply the denominator of a. Here the denominator of a is s, denominator a with the x of s. Then I have to put wherever I have s, I have to put s. Okay, now if you substitute x of s here, this s and s will be cancel each other. Okay, after that you have to substitute wherever you are having s, you have to put 0. If you are substituting 0 mean, it will be a divided by, that is 1 divided by 12. So finally a is equal to 1 divided by 12. Similarly, the same procedure to find out b and c. B is equal to s plus 3 into x of s. S plus 3 is what? It is the denominator of b. And x of s, if you are substituting, means s plus 3 and s plus 3 will cancel each other. The finally, I have to substitute, instead of s, I have to substitute minus 3. Okay, so if you are substituting minus 3, after this simplifications, after these simplifications, finally you will get b is equal to minus 25 divided by 3. Similarly, to find out the residue c, the denominator of c is s plus 4. And x of s, instead of x of s, I'm going to substitute the original value. Then s plus 4 and s plus 4 will be cancel each other. Then instead of s, I have to put minus 4. That is, s plus 4 is equal to 0. S is equal to minus 4. If you substitute instead of s, minus 4, after these simplifications, these are just mathematical operations. After this simplification, I will get finally c is equal to 25 divided by 4. Now I have to substitute all the values of a, b, c in the original expression that we seen here. Here I have to substitute the value of a, b, c. Okay. After doing this substitution, I have to go for the step 2. Whatever we seen till now, that is step 1. Now this is the step 2. I have to apply the inverse Laplace transform to the partial fraction to x of s. So this is inverse Laplace transform of x of s, then inverse Laplace transform, that is 1 divided by 12, it just taken here, 1 divided by 12, here it is, you just take it out, then it will be a Laplace, inverse Laplace transform of 1 divided by s, then minus 25 divided by 3, inverse Laplace of 1 divided by s plus 3, then 25 divided by 4, inverse Laplace transform 1 divided by s plus 4. So using the standard Laplace transform pairs, we can easily find out the inverse Laplace transform here, because we know that Laplace transform of u of t is 1 divided by s, then Laplace transform of e power minus at u of t is 1 divided by s plus a. So here, to find out the inverse Laplace transform, I have to find out. So here, it is the s domain signal is 1 divided by s, means the time domain signal will be u of t. So for this, I'm going to use this pair. For these two, I'm going to use this pair. Here, a is equal to 3. Here, a is equal to 4. Okay. So after doing this, using standard inverse Laplace transform pairs, Laplace transform pairs, I will get this. So I'm going to take the u of t common from the previous equation. Okay. Next we will see example 2. So example 2, here we have another pattern of S domain signal. Okay, it is a given x of s. X of s is equal to 2 into s square plus 10s in plus 7, then divided by s plus 1 into s square plus 3s plus 2. Okay, so always you have to try to represent the given denominator part of the x of s into a factorized form, a simple factors. Okay, simple factors. So here we can write, given s square, given denominator, this is s square plus 3s plus 2 can be represented as s plus 1 to s plus 2, a simple factors. That is, if you multiply these two terms, you will get this original term. To find out these two terms, it is easily, you can find out the quadratic. This is a quadratic equation. If you solve this quadratic equation, you will get some roots, minus 1 and minus 2. So it will be written as s plus 1. If this minus 1 minus 2 come to the left hand side, means s plus 1 and s plus 2. These are the two factors of the given this quadratic equation. Okay, so now you are having the denominator, a simple first order parts. So this s plus 1 and s plus 1, it's called multiple roots. This is called multiple roots or repeated roots. This will be written as s plus 1 squared. Okay, now the x of s has been represented like this. X of s is using partial fraction a divided by s plus 2. This is the step one of the inverse Laplace transform. The given x of s should be represented as the sum of first order and RR. Here represented first order and second order polynomial. Okay, so to find out the value of a, you have to multiply the denominator of a with the x of s. This is your original x of s given in the problem, not in the problem, after doing the simplification, this is what you are having. Okay, so here it is s plus 2 and s plus 2 will cancel each other, and instead of s I have to put minus 2. If you are substituting instead of s, minus 2 here, everywhere where you are having s, you are going to substitute minus 2. After substituting, you will get this minus 2 squared 4, then minus 2 multiplied with 10 means minus 20. It will be next step, then minus 2 on plus 1, that will be minus 1 squared. So finally, after doing all the simplification, this will be minus 5. So value of a is minus 5. Next, to find out the residue b, I have to put denominator of b is s plus 1 squared into x of s. You have to put s is equal to minus 1, because s plus 1 is equal to 0, then s is equal to minus 1. Okay, then if you substitute x of s here, the s plus 1 squared whole squared will be cancel each other. Then instead of s, I have to put minus 1. If you are substituting after simplification, you will get minus 1. So value of b is minus 1. Then to find out the c value, somehow it is different from previous two methods, previous two residues. So here this step up to this step, it is same. That is, when you are calculating the b up to this step, you are having s plus 1 whole square, and here also the same one, s plus 1 whole square x of s. Then after substituting this, these two will cancel each other. Then you have to take the differentiation for this part. Okay, if you are differentiating this part using the standard formula, that's d divided by ds, u divided by v, that will be divided by v squared, the du divided by ds into v, then dv divided by ds into u. So if you are putting denominator part, that is s plus 2 whole squared, it will be, because this is your u and this is your v. Okay, so this is v squared du divided by ds. I'm differentiating this part, du divided by ds, it will be this, because if you're differentiating, it will be 2s squared, so it will be 2s after differentiation. So 4s, then 10s, if you are differentiating, that will be 10. Then s plus 2 is v. V I have to just to put as it is. Then I have to differentiate v now, dv divided by ds. So v is s plus 2. If you are differentiating the s, that will be 1. If you are differentiating the constant, that will be 0. So it is dv divided by ds is 1. Then I have to put the value of u here. So After multiplying inside, you will get this, this part. So 4s square into s, that will be 4s into s, that will be 4s square. Then 4s into 2, that will be 8s. Then 10 into s, that will be 10s. 10 into 2, that will be 20. And you have to just put as it is, and you have to take the minus sign inside. So the 10s, 10s will cancel each other. Finally, I have to put s is equal to minus 1 everywhere. Okay. So if you are substituting s is equal to minus 1, after here, after doing all the simplifications, after doing all the simplification, finally you will get 7. So finally c is equal to 7. So you have to substitute all the residues a, b and c into your partial fraction form, that is minus 5 divided by s plus 2, then minus 1 divided by s plus 1 whole square, because this is the value of a, and minus 1 is the value of b, and 7 is the value of c. Okay, after substituting all this, I have to go for the step 2. Step 2. Now you have to take the inverse Laplace transform using standard Laplace transform pairs. Okay. Here we are going to use two standard Laplace transform pair, that is e power minus at u of t is 1 divided by s plus a, then t into e power minus at u of t will be 1 divided by s plus a whole squared. Okay, here I am going to use here and here, I am going to use this first Laplace transform pair, here I am going to use this second Laplace transform pair. Okay, here the a value is 2, here the a value is 1, and here the a value is 1. Okay, so after using this standard Laplace transform pairs, I will get x of t as minus 5 e power minus 2 t u of t minus t into e power minus t u of t plus 7 into e power minus t u of t. Now I will take a u of t common, and here e power minus t also you can take common. From here, if I am taking minus e power minus a t u of t common, 7 will be remaining. Here minus 5 e power minus 2 t can be written as e power minus t into e power minus t. So I taken 1 e power, that is out of the 2 I have take 1 minus e power t and u of t common. So another 1 e power e t will be remaining here. Then here I have taken this part outside, means the remaining part will be t. So it is a simplification part, it's not compulsory how to do it. So this part is really important. This is the Laplace transform, inverse Laplace transform of the given original given signal. Okay, this is the simplification part, it is not mandatory. Okay, this part is really important. Okay, now we will see example 3. This is the third type of inverse Laplace transform problem. Here the x of s is equal to 3s square plus 8s plus 23 divided by s plus 3 into s square plus 2s plus 10s. Here we can represent the x of s in this form, a divided by s plus 3 plus bs plus 3 bs plus c divided by s square plus 2s plus 10. Why we are representing this term as a quadratic form? Because we cannot write this given second order polynomial into a simple factor, something like s plus 1 plus s plus 2, in this simple form. Because for this case, you will get a complex root, something like a plus j b and a minus j. Complex conjugate roots only you will get for this particular polynomial. if you not able to get the simple roots like this, s is equal to minus 1 comma minus 2, something like that, you have to write the given second order polynomial as it is. The numerator part, if it is a simple root, means only a constant term will come in the numerator. If it is a first order function, means then simple constant will come in the numerator. If it is a second order polynomial, means here it will be numerator part will be a first order polynomial, okay, that is BS plus C. So after this, I'm going to find out the value of A, because value of A I can easily find out like I did for the previous problems, because it has denominator part is simple roots. Okay, so S plus 3 denominator of A into X of S. If you are substituting X of S, the original given question X of S, that is S plus 3 and S plus 3 will cancel each other. Then instead of S, I have to put minus 3. If you are substituting minus 3 in wherever you are having S, I'm going to substitute minus 3. After doing all these simplifications, I will get finally A is equal to 2. Now, to find out the value of B and C, I have to follow a different steps from the previous examples. This is the original X of S is given. Okay. So, I have to continue from the step here. Suppose I am telling this is equation 1, means I have to continue from that equation. Instead of A, I have to put 2. Then this is the thing which is already in the equation 1. Now I am going to do cross multiplication. Cross multiplication in right hand side. If you do the cross multiplication, this will be 2 into s square plus 2s plus 10, and this will be bs plus c into s plus 3. Then denominator part will be s plus 3 into s square plus 2s plus 10. These two will cancel each other. Then if you multiply inside, it will be 2s squared, 2 into 2 4s, then 2 into 10 20, then bs into s squared, that is bs squared, then bs into 3, that will be 3bs, then c into s cs, 3 into c into 3, that is 3c. Now I'm going to segregate the s power terms separately. So now if you take out the s squared terms, the coefficient of s squared, here you have s squared and here you have s squared. So coefficient s squared is 2 plus b. Like the same way, coefficients of s, 4, here you have 4s, then here 3s, and here it will be cs. So 4 plus 3b plus c, these are the coefficients of s. Then remaining things are constant. Now I am going to equate the s squared terms from the left hand side and right hand side and left hand side. I am going to equate the s squared terms, coefficient s squared terms. Here s squared coefficient is 3. Here s squared coefficient is 2 plus b. From this I can easily find out the value of b. So b is equal to 3 minus 2. That is 1. Then again I am going to equate s power 0, that is constant terms, because I'm going, why I'm doing this, I'm not equating the s power 1, because that is not needed. Because what I need to find out the value of b and value of c. If you equate this, you can easily find out using this also, because already you found value of b. Okay, for example, you see, if you are equating the coefficient of s, means 4 plus 3b plus c, that is equal to 8s. Now 4 plus 3 into b value is 1 plus c, that is equal to 8. So c is equal to 8 minus 7, that is equal to 1. But it is taking too much extra steps. But if you are equating the coefficient of constants, if you are equating the constant, then it will be single step. That is 23 is the constant value in the left hand side. Then 20 plus 3c is the constant value in the right hand side. Then 3c is equal to 23 minus 20. C is equal to 1. So just you can find out the value of C from this or from this. Okay. So finally you found A, B, C, everything. Now you have to substitute this A, B, C values in the equation 1. In the equation 1, I have to substitute. If you are substituting, A is 2, then B value is 1, then C value also 1. Okay. Now I have to do some modification. One thing you have to remember, that I already mentioned in the partial fraction expansion video also, whenever you are having the complex roots, your inverse Laplace transform will have sin omega t or cos omega t or both in the inverse Laplace transform. So you have to modify the this part. This is a simple root, so you can easily convert the, you can directly convert into inverse Laplace transform using the standard Laplace transform pairs. You can directly convert into x of t form. Okay, but this is, you have to do some modification to find out the inverse Laplace transform. So here s plus 1, this s plus 1 is the numerator part. Okay, suppose I am telling this is the standard transform pair. This is the standard transform pair, that is e power minus a t cos omega t u of t. To bring for this Laplace transform will be s plus a whole squared plus omega squared. So I am going to bring this part into that form, that is s plus a divided by s plus a whole squared plus omega squared. So for that, what I have to do, I have to write this given denominator part. Here it is, numerator part is what? S plus 1. So a value is 1. I can easily tell. So I have to write s plus a whole squared in the denominator. S plus 1 whole squared form I had write means what should be? S squared plus 2 s plus 1. So I am going to separate this s square plus 2s plus 10 into s square plus 2s plus 1 plus 9. Now this can be written as s plus 1 whole squared. This can be written as s plus 1 whole squared. This can be written as 3 squared. So now instead of omega, this omega is what here now? It is now 3. Now it is a kind of simple simplification. Okay, now we are going to take, this is now our step 2. Now I am going to take the inverse Laplace transform of x of s using standard Laplace transform pairs. Here I am going to use this Laplace transform pair. Here I am going to use this Laplace transform pair. Finally, you will get x of t is equal to 2 into e power minus 3 t u of t, because here a value is 3, here a value is 1, then omega value is 3. If you are substituting, here a value is 3 means a value is 1, so e power minus t, then cos 3 t u of t, that will be the inverse Laplace transform of this part, that is e power minus t cos 3 t u of t. Now I am going to take the u of t common. Now the x of t is equal to 2 e power minus 3 t plus e power minus t cos 3 t, then the whole outside is u of t. So these are the three different types of inverse Laplace transforms. Hopefully you understood everything what I discussed here. If you have any doubt, please put your doubt in the comment box. I will try to solve your doubts. Okay, thank you very much.